I've been thinking a lot about this friend of mine recently. I wrote about her in the introduction to the Pleasure Principle. I love her to bits, and she's such a good friend, and she has such a big heart, and she's the perfect person to have fun with. And yet she's still single because she's hung up on this boy that she used to love in high school. And he's a grown man now, and he lets her come over on the weekends. And sometimes he dangles a promise of a ring, but that would mean giving up his bachelor life and getting his drinking under control and letting a woman share his space. And he's not ready for that. This guy really has the best of all possible worlds. He has my friend whenever he wants her, because if he texts her, she will be over in a shot. She's in love with him, and she always has been. She will never lay down boundaries or give him an ultimatum, because that might mean losing the little bit of attention she's got right now. And she has told herself that she's content with the way things are. She tells herself that this suits her because, you know, she's busy and she's got a lot going on herself, and she doesn't really have time for a relationship. But she still talks about him with stars in her eyes, even though sometimes the frustration does seep through. Sometimes she tells me she hates men and they're all jerks, because I think deep in her heart, she knows he's playing her. But what is she supposed to do? He's in the power seat. He knows she is waiting for him, and she will give him everything, regardless of whether he wants a future with her or not. So she's stuck, and she shrugs off the hurt and she pretends it doesn't bother her. But of course it does, right? How could it not? This man has had her heart for over a decade, and he doesn't care. But I care. I get so mad. I want my friend to realize that he's not the only fish in the sea, and she's so desirable and amazing, so much more than she realizes. And if she only got to experience a man treating her well, she'd never go back to this guy. But I can say that, can't I? Because I know deep in my bones that whenever I'm ready for love, I can make that happen, right? Because I'm in the driver's seat of my life. I can make the choices that are right for me. But my friend feels like she doesn't have any choices. She lives in this area where there's very few single men. She works all the time. She rarely goes out, and she doesn't do online dating. So this guy is all she's got. There's no one else. She has to make this work. I can't believe I'm going to teach you a concept from pickup artists of all people, but pickup artists have a concept for this situation that can be really helpful. They call it one-itis. One-itis is when you get fixated on one person. And that person is the only person you want. You don't have eyes for anyone else. And so you study the dating and the seduction skills for the specific purpose of winning over that person. And you don't dare to imagine what will happen if you fail, because life has no meaning if you can't be with them. This person has your heart in the palm of their hand, but they're bouncing it up and down like it's a toy. They're not personally invested in you. They enjoy your adoration, sure, because it's flattering. But other times they just seem irritated by you because they know you want more from them. They have all the power and you have none. Now, one-itis is different from true love, because when you're in a true love relationship, his heart is open and he's trying to make it work because he knows that this kind of love doesn't happen every day. The other women he's dated are like badly fitting clothes. They're all too big or too small or too scratchy. And you are the only woman he's been with who fits him like a glove. But when it's one-itis, he acts like you're the one who doesn't fit. And he chooses you only when he doesn't have other options. And you want him. You believe you could have an amazing life together. You love him. And you don't have any other options because you have staked everything on this guy. And you'll wait for him to make up his mind. You will be there even if he dates someone else. Does that make him appreciate your loyalty and love even more? No, it doesn't. It can be really hard to wrap yourself around this idea that adoring a man and giving him your whole heart is the least effective way to change his mind. As women, we've been raised to believe that that's the most beautiful gift you can give someone, to tell them, I am yours. Completely, utterly, and forever. I recently watched that classic Christmas movie, The Holiday, with Kate Winslet, Cameron Diaz. And my favorite moment in that movie is when Kate Winslet's character realizes that she has been giving her heart away to a man who only sees her as his side piece. She so wanted to believe that he felt the same way about her. He knew all of the right things to say to keep stringing her along. But when she wakes up and she finally chooses herself and her happiness over him, I always feel like cheering, because that is the only thing that gets a man like that to value you. Walking away and living life on your terms. Guys like that won't value you until you value yourself. When you choose yourself over a man, it actually changes his mind about you. He no longer sees you as this puppy dog he can call whenever he's bored. He sees you as a woman who won't put up with his stuff, who won't stay around unless he changes his behavior, and who won't wait around until he makes up his mind. Now, yes, it is utterly terrifying to walk away from a man that you have staked all of your hopes and dreams on. But you're not walking away from love. You're actually walking towards love, because he was never offering you love. He was offering you companionship, some empty compliments. You're the one with a huge heart who believes in people and is incredibly loyal. Now it's time to turn all those beautiful qualities onto the one person who will always be there for you. You. Give yourself all of the love and all of the compliments and all of the nice things you'd normally give him, and see how wonderful it feels to be loved by you. So if you're stuck in one-itis and you're waiting for a guy to choose you, this is what I recommend. Choose yourself. Your heart is yours, always and forever. When I think about my friend, I kind of feel like I love her more than she loves herself, because I see the beauty in her that she refuses to see. I value our friendship and I value her. She thinks that she won't be able to find anyone else because she doesn't like some things about how she looks. She doesn't like some aspects of her life. But then again, she leads with the assumption that she's going to be rejected. So she doesn't even put herself out there. She won't online date. She won't open herself up to new experiences. She would never assume that that guy talking to her might want to get to know her better. So she's not going to see all the possibilities around her until she stops giving her love away where it's not reciprocated and starts filling herself up with love. So that's what my program, The Pleasure Principle, is all about. It's about helping you take back the power that you've been giving away. It helps you charge yourself up so that men see you as someone to be reckoned with. The Pleasure Principle shifts the balance of power in your relationship so that he can go from dismissing you as someone he could take for granted to wanting nothing more than being the one to please you. So do it for yourself. Look, if you need the structure of the program, I encourage you to get The Pleasure Principle. But regardless, start today making your pleasure a priority. You don't need to make him happy. He needs to see himself as the only man who can make you happy. Take really, really good care of yourself, and I will see you next time.